Rob Van Dam, Mr. Monday Night, the whole effing show. Rob is an individual that showcased athletic ability and at the same time introduced the audience of sports entertainment to the word extreme. Rob beats to his own drum. His ability is second to none. What he can do in the air and his flexibility, it makes him one of a kind. And I think that theme song fits him very well.
I'm cashing in the money in the bank at One Night Stand.
Whew. ECW One Night Stand in the famed Hammerstein Ballroom. The crowd was the best crowd I've ever performed in front of. They were all rooting for Rob Van Dam. The crowd was the show. We were just performing around them. This small group was so enthusiastic that it's a night I remember like it was yesterday. It was more than just Rob Van Dam versus John Cena. It was an underdog company versus the powerhouse that is WWE. It was something I've never experienced after that, and I don't know if I'll ever experience again. Even when it seems like the whole entire world is against you, if there was one fan still rooting for me in that crowd, I was gonna fight for him. And I was gonna fight for anyone cheering me on, watching at home. Even in the most hostile environment, I wasn't gonna abandon the people that had my back, and I was gonna fight for them at ECW One Night Stand.
Yeah.
So fast. I didn't find out till very late that I was, you know, gonna accept an open challenge with Kurt Angle.
There are a lot of young guys back there that want to climb that ladder to success. Well, now's your chance. to become a sensation just like me.
He is one of the most gifted and decorated superstars in WWE history. He prides himself on being in great condition, and he expects physically the best out of anybody he steps in there with. I wouldn't have had it happen any other way because I didn't have time to think about it. It's like, hey, you're doing this. When? You got 5 minutes.
This is John Cena, who could be looking to knock on the door of opportunity. What?
Ruthless aggression.
Kurt showed that even though I was ready to be in a WWE ring, I wasn't yet at the levels of the WWE's greatest superstars. But I was going to put in the work to get there as soon as I possibly could. Looking back on it now, 20 years later, I was trying to earn the respect of my peers when my focus should have been to earn the respect of the audience. And thank goodness I got a chance to learn that rather quickly. You know, here we're talking about a 20-year retrospective, and that doesn't happen without the first step. And I'm grateful to have such a demanding challenge.
Here.
Thoughts on The Undertaker as an opponent. That's a luxury. He's the greatest. Or has to be included in that conversation, like tip of the spear. Is one of the very few, that uses aura and mystique completely to his advantage, in a very legitimate sense. Whether you get swept up in the moment, where you just lose focus. He's someone that carries a certain aura about him, and this is undeniable. And I figured there wasn't a better statement than, like, go after the one everybody thinks is the man, and that's The Undertaker. And don't do it like you did in your debut. Don't go up to him and shake his hand and say, thanks for saying I did great, sir. In the moment, it was awesome. You know, looking back on it 20 years later, I went out there saying the one thing I have that Kurt Angle doesn't have is
ruthless aggression.
And then when someone of merit comes and shakes my hand, what do? Oh, thank you so much. Nothing for me as a superstar. But the cool thing is I learned that and then kind of put it into practice in 2003. I remember talking a whole lot of trash about him on the lead up to this match.
And in vengeance, I'm gonna prove the big dog is all bark.
I had such a chip on my shoulder. I kind of had a rebirth, the hip hop John Cena, the doctor of thugonomics. I thought I was gonna shock the world. That's how ready I was. Boy, was I wrong. So my confidence got to be arrogance, and that I was served a huge slice of humble pie. I had to face the music after talking a lot of trash and came up short.
Thank you.
So we talked about 2003, and let's fast forward a, I don't know, a decade and a half. I'm kind of at a loss, and I hit a bit of a rough patch where I was kind of running out of options to participate in WrestleMania. I can't muster a win in the Rumble. The next opportunity I have, I squander. So with about a month to go, I was put in a corner of like, how do I get to WrestleMania? I came up with an idea to look to the one attraction that is associated with WrestleMania. WrestleMania is The Undertaker. If I could drum up enough interest from the WWE Universe, maybe this would be something that they'd want to see. And if they want to see it, I'm really not forcing myself on like, I get this opportunity just because I'm John Cena. So I went on TV and I called him out.
Well, screw it. I challenge The Undertaker to a match at WrestleMania.
And no one had heard from The Undertaker, no one had seen The Undertaker, nobody knew what The Undertaker's position was, whether he was gonna show up or not. But every week, I would let the WWE Universe know, like, this is something you wanna see, right? And overwhelmingly, they would let me know that it was. So this meeting, which is actually one of my favorite build-ups to a WrestleMania, and one of my favorite WrestleManias of all time, happened out of desperation. The mystique of being in a WrestleMania ring with The Undertaker is special. And this one was a great story. I'll never forget this WrestleMania experience. I really won't. It was special to me because it was the first time in about 15 to 20 years I got to watch WrestleMania as a fan. I always have to peek through the curtain. I got to go out and sit there. I could lose myself in the pageantry. I could lose myself in the event. And having that opportunity, that very rare opportunity, to see WrestleMania from both sides, from over the barricade and then in the ring, and then when you're in the ring, be in there with The Undertaker, that's what makes it absolutely unforgettable. There is no shame in losing to The Undertaker, especially at WrestleMania. Now, I called him out, and I had to pay the price for it. But seeing the spotlight back on The Undertaker after he defeated me so quickly, you know, that made it a whole lot easier to handle.
Thank you. You can't see me.
Beep, beep.